Hey guys, hope everybody as well as a great life.
So excited.
We're doing
so
Boston, excited. Than a feeling, much anticipated by us and you guys, I think.
I made a pun about more than a feeling.
In the smoking video, I think.
Yeah, a while ago.
I did not
And
catch
now
it
we finally get
all.
To hear if it, like, the actual payoff on that punchline. Because I'm so excited to hear this. This is like their fucking song. Yeah.
This is apparently one of the songs where you guys have said it's like one of those songs that like everyone's heard, and that like when we hear it, we'll know that we've heard it before. But like when I hear the words like more than a feeling, like no tune whatsoever comes to my head.
Yeah,
but I wonder if it will be that case to where like the second it like the chorus hits, I'm like, oh.
It seemed like such
song,
a big song.
You know?
I was like, it must have been in movies or commercials or something. But I mean, I'm just hyped to actually fucking hear the song.
Same. And some people have said that we've been overhyping it a little bit.
Really?
So I'm gonna humble myself.
But can you overhype a Boston song?
And objectively go into this with an open mind so I don't get disappointed if my bar is set super high. So I'm gonna level my bar. And I'll let Boston do to me what they want to do. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
With that said, let's go and check it out, dude. More than a feeling.
Thank you.
I just feel like that's like a timeless song.
Dude, that felt... Hold on. This is a headphone off kind of moment.
It really is.
That felt honestly flawless to me, dude.
The way they transitioned into the chorus with that guitar into line,
every part,
it's just
every transitions are notoriously hard. They can be rough. It can be difficult to do a bunch of different like sounding, because this had a bunch of different sounding things. Now, one thing I'll say starting off before we like get heavily into it, I saw the comments too that was like, oh, you might be overhyping this song, right? Potentially, right? Now, what I think maybe what they were trying to say, or maybe at least what I got from that, is this is not the quote-unquote banger that some of those other... This isn't Smoking, yeah. And this isn't... Or, like, it's that's not that, like, mm-hmm. high-energy craziness. This felt super mature. Like, that to me, it felt mature.
Polished. Polished. Well, this is the album opening, I think. Or I know it's at least inside one, for sure.
It felt to me like they weren't trying to prove anything. They were just like... And not that they were with other songs, but Some of them, other ones felt more bombastic, and this didn't have that. But everything felt so right and so collected, mm-hmm. where they're like, we don't need to throw stuff at the wall. This is just like boiled down to the essential parts. Like everything in here is necessary, and nothing that isn't necessary is there. I don't know. That was my feeling.
They didn't feel like redundant. Anytime they repeated like the chorus, it just felt like as genuine as the first time they did it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like I said before, the guitar line into it really just like sealed
it hung on that note. Like You notice that like the vocals didn't come in on the start of it. Like it let the note, that guitar solo note, hung, and then right as the vocals came in, it started trailing off completely.
It was just calculated, man.
The production of this is so good. It's so good. It's so polished. It's so like the production of this is really what shined through to me.
Yep. I would say I definitely feel like I had heard, like, the first part of the chorus at some like, young age. I'm talking, like, 8 years old. I'm in the car or, like, watching a movie. And I just hear the... You know, like, I got a certain memory of it. And it feels really, like, enlightening to have, like... Because, you know, like, you've heard songs like that growing up or whatever. And you never hear them again. Like, great songs. And then you revisit them when you're older. And you're like, oh, crap. Like, that was this song. But you didn't even know. You know? So, like... It just felt like good, you know, to like hear it like in its entirety. And just
one thing I also want to say, bass line, I feel like it's underrated. That bass line, he was like just tucked in the back, but you could hear him right as the song, like right when he kicks in, like he's not just like hitting the whole notes. He's not fucking diamonding. He's like just going pretty nuts
a little bit. Fat, dude.
And he's just kind of going off on his own thing and really like. Like, because the song, the drums are really tame in a lot of it. Like, the fills are just do-do-do-ba-da-da. Like, you know, fallen and not... They're not crazy.
Standard by-the-book fills, dude.
Yeah, and it's just... It's what's necessary. But the bass line is like, all right, well, I'm going to add that rhythmic dynamic that maybe is lacking if it wasn't there.
It's true.
Rating.
So, I'm trying to figure my ratings. At this point, we've heard at least, like, 6 other Boston songs or so from this debut. So, I'm trying to hold it up against those songs. And I do feel like... I feel from a technical like standpoint, objectively, I do like Foreplay Long Time better and Hitch a Ride. This might be up for hard debate in the comments, but that's just like my personal feel. But we also have a very emotional experience with Hitch a Ride.
Hitch a Ride was a different thing. If we would have heard this for Hitch a Ride, like in Hitch a Ride's place,
yeah.
I don't know, dude.
But dude, I give this a solid 9.99.
Dude, I'm giving it a 10.
Give it a 10, dude.
I think this is a 10. I mean, to me, like I said, I think you're right. Foreplay Long Time is like more bombastic, mm-hmm. more high energy. Same thing with Smokin'. Both of those are so powerful in their delivery, mm-hmm. but this one just felt confident and mature in its delivery in a way that was so precise.
This is a song that you have to show your kid. You know what I mean?
Yeah, this
like,
is just,
this is one of those songs that you really do to kind of have to like, if you have a friend that has not heard of the song, you kind of like, it's almost like your duty to like introduce it to them. If you're gonna show anybody a Boston song, any Boston song, this is probably the one to show them. Yep. Is it their best song? Up for debate. But like, is it the song that everyone should probably hear if they're gonna hear any at all? Probably.
I can agree with that.
You know what I'm saying?
Gosh, so, that was amazing.
Fat song,
guys.
Man.
Oh, that was a crazy Boston journey, guys.
Really was. So let us know which songs are worth checking out from the second and third album. I know I've seen a lot of like back and forth in the comments of like whether it's like as good or not, blah blah blah, all this and that. But the consensus that I've come to from reading all of your comments was that there are gems scattered through the next couple
We're
going
albums. To listen to them. So, yeah, period. So we're going to figure that out. We're going to make the decision when we fucking come to it.
100%.
Also, let us know other bands that are maybe like this or other bands that I know...
Arena rock, basically. I think that's like what the genre is. I think it consists of bands like Boston, Kansas, which I've only heard one Kansas song, which is Carry My Wayward Son. But we have had a lot of suggestions.
I think my mom used to play Dust in the Wind as a kid, like on a guitar.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's Kansas.
I have no idea.
I think it's Kansas. She used to play Dust in the Wind. I don't know who that's by. I don't know if I've actually heard the song other than her sing it either.
Right. But tell us all about it. With that said, what are other arena rock bands that we should be checking out? And with that said, we'll see you guys next time. Have a fantastic day.
That was great.